And your body will tell you when you're hungry. Some of us, our mood changes when we're hungry. We're easily agitated when we are hungry. You can't say amen, say ouch. And we're not satisfied until we get something to eat. I'm talking about the natural. Now, whether you realize it or not, God has made us as human beings not only natural, but we also spiritual. And our spirit man desires something. It hungers. It thirsts. And if we lean to our own understanding, our spirit man wants some change. Our spirit man will want something that is not good for us. Now, when I say cake, our spirit man want a party, want a fornicate, sensual and sexual desires. And if we don't fulfill those desires, our life just doesn't seem right. And it's not right. Because you need something. Amen. Most people in the world, they don't see Jesus as being a bread. But Jesus will, if you ingest him, all the sinful desires, he will change your appetite. But we still have to find a positive for another blessed week. Thank you for my life, my health, and my strength. I glorify you. I magnify you. And I praise you. Thank you for your son Jesus dying on the cross for me. Thank you for the chance to be adopted into your family. I pray that I am a light unto someone else. Let them see you in me. I glorify you. I magnify you. And I praise you. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. And amen once again. Come on, let's give the Lord another hand of praise. Hallelujah. If you will, just lift your hands unto the Lord. Let the Lord know how much you really love him in the house tonight. I really love you, Lord. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. for your son Jesus, coming and dying on the cross for our sin. We thank you for saving us. We thank you for all the times you healed our body. And Lord, we just want to take a little time to really honor you. Because of who you are. Lord, there is no telling what we would be if you had not intervened in our lives. And Lord, we just want to let you know that we thank you, we praise you, and we glorify you. In Jesus' name. Come on, choir, I thank you. praise the Lord.
Amen.
Even the sinner man, you may be seated.
Amen.
Even the sinner man
can praise the Lord.
Worship is a different story.
Yes.
But everybody,
everybody
can praise the Lord.
Amen.
In order to worship him, you have to be saved. You have to be able to get into
the
inner court from the inside.
Amen.
But praise is something that can be done externally from the outside.
Right.
So again, everybody, ought to praise the Lord. Again, we thank God for allowing us another opportunity to come together and praise and worship unto him, because he has been so good to us. And those who are saved, you really understand what I'm talking about when I say that.
Amen.
The main and most important thing that he has done in our life is saved us from our sin. We understand what our final destination was going to be. And we allow the Lord to intercept our lives, our way of thinking, our whole attitude towards sin. And in doing so, he delivered us. Many of us in here tonight, if we would have continued on with our lifestyle, we would not be here today. We would already be in hell. But God, through his son Jesus, saved us. Again, changed our appetite for sin. So that's why we celebrate. When we come to the house of the Lord, we celebrate salvation. It's not about material wealth or material gain, because the world can have that. Many people in the world have money. They have fancy houses and cars, but they don't have Jesus. We have something that is priceless. No matter how much money you have, you don't have enough to buy it. But again, we just thank God again for giving it to us through his son Jesus. And we encourage everyone, especially those who are not saved, to seriously consider allowing the Lord to come into your life. He will make the difference in your life. And we do invite you, if you ever are in the Central Georgia area, to feel free to come and be a part of our services. We are in three locations. We're in Forsyth, Georgia, Fort Valley, Georgia, and here in Lazola, Georgia. And our services begin every Sunday morning with Sunday school, starting at 9 a.m. And we encourage everyone to come to Sunday school, because this is where you're going to learn more, because you have an opportunity to put your inputs in on the class, to ask questions, whereas in a regular normal church setting or service, if you have a question about the message, you can't ask it. But in Sunday school, you are free. And in your Bible studies, that's where you're going to learn more, because you have an opportunity to express your thoughts and ideas on whatever that is being discussed that day. So again, we encourage everybody to come to Sunday school. That's the most important service. You know? And after Sunday school, going to a morning worship service, and it begins at all three church locations at 11 a.m. And in our morning service, everyone is free to testify, to tell the goodness of the Lord. Everyone who is saved has a testimony. The Lord delivered you from something, and he set you free. And so what we do in our morning service, again, everyone is open to testify, to tell of your experience in life, what you have gone through, what you may even be going through, and positively and negatively. Because as we have learned, everything that happens in our life has a purpose behind it. It's according to God's purpose. And it works together for good. You know, so again, we just thank God that what goes on in our morning service. And then we are convening in Lazella for our evening service beginning at 7 p.m. And this But those of you who are watching my Facebook, this is the service.
Amen.
And you are viewing. Those of you who are watching my television, quite oftentimes it's almost a month later before you see that actual service, this service. But it will be filmed and broadcast then. So again, we just thank God for everything that he's doing within this ministry. And our address here is 7545 Knoxville Road, Lonsdale, Georgia. If you have a navigation system, just enter that address into your navigation system, and it will lead you from wherever you are in the continental United States to this location.
Amen.
If you desire our other addresses to our sister churches, that information is available on the church website, which is www.lizellachurch.com.
Amen.
And when you get to that web, whenever you open that web, our web page up, first thing I want you to do is to look at the trash page.
Right.
Because that's the most important page on the website. There we have several tracts written by the founder of this ministry,
Amen.
Apostle Albert Phelps.
Amen.
And if you go there and read those tracts, you will see how we have been taught and how we are continuing to teach.
Amen.
And then after you read those tracts, we don't have all of them that he wrote. Those are just a few.
Amen.
And after you read those, and if you want more, contact us and we will send them to you, other tracts that he also wrote. And if you desire direct to our sister church, click on the maps and addresses button.
Yes.
Upon doing so, click on the location you desire to attend.
Amen.
Then you will see that address.
Yes.
You can either put that into your navigation system,
right,
or you can use the website.
Right.
Yes. If you click on the location you desire to attend, you will be able to enter in a starting address, and your device will generate a map,
Amen.
That will lead you from wherever you are to any of our sister churches. So that information is available at the church website. And we thank God for those of you who are contributing to the ministry, those of you who are mailing to the ministry. Our mailing address is 7697 Knoxville Road, Lonsdale, Georgia. Zip code 31052. And we are getting feedback from many people through mail and also through telephone of what the ministry is meaning to them and how it has blessed them.
Yes.
If you notice, we're not a fundraising ministry. We don't do any fundraisers. If you notice on our television broadcast, we don't sell anything. And the only thing that we do is ask for a donation.
Right.
If you desire any of our media, even the one you are viewing right now, know the number that's on your screen.
Amen.
And when you contact us, give us this number, and we will send this one to you at our cost.
That's right.
Only thing we ask is that after you receive it, that you consider that there is a cost and to send a donation of how the Lord has blessed you. That's the way the founder of this ministry set it up.
Right.
Apostle Phelps was not a man about raising money for the church, nor for himself.
Amen.
And we are continuing on in the same manner.
Amen.
The church does not raise money for senior pastor or for myself or for any of our pastors. But we all, everyone, even people in this ministry, they volunteer to do everything that is necessary for this ministry to continue. We don't have to hire cleanup crews to come in after church service to come in and clean up. We have volunteers that do that. We don't have to hire people to do yard work for our church license. And there is not a church anywhere that has a lot as pretty as ours be. So again, we just thank God for those who volunteer to do that work within the ministry.
Amen.
And at, quite oftentimes at the functions that we have within the ministry, we have people that volunteer to do food and all those type of items. So we thank those who do that type of work and within the ministry. And many times we need repairs, and we have people in the ministry that have talents that God has given them, and they help the ministry out by using their talents to repair whatever that needs to be repaired in the ministry. So again, that's how we function. That's how we're able to do what we do. Especially as far as television ministry. Because if you check it out, you will see it's not cheap. Not only do you have to pay for the broadcast, but you have to pay for your equipment. You have to keep your equipment up to date. And professional equipment is not cheap. You know, there's a difference between consumer or prosumer and professional. And so whenever you start talking about professional cameras, you're talking about some money. And so again, we just thank God again for him allowing us to do what we do.
Amen.
As far as television ministry. You notice we now have a large congregation. All of those probably can fit in one section. And still have plenty of room. And so again, we always spread all out, all over. So again, if you want to dance, whatever, you got plenty of room. You don't have to worry about bumping into anybody. So again, we just thank God again for the people that we do have. And if God can do it for us, he can do it for you too. He can do it for your church, your ministry too. So again, just want to give you that little bit of information. And I do want to let you know, as I said earlier, we're on Facebook. If you would like to link up with us there, just do a search for the Lazella Pentecostal Church. When you find us, like us, and you will be notified of everything that we have coming up in the ministry. Whenever we go live, you can see it.
Right.
You know, we had an event yesterday, and I posted some of the what we had going on on Facebook on yesterday. And we just thank God for who he is. And if you're on Twitter, you can also communicate with us that way also. Just do a search for @LizPentyChurch. And whenever you find us, you can like us there. And we can tweet back and forth. So we thank God for all the avenues of communication that the Lord has opened up. You know, a lot of times people say, that's still bad. It's how you use it. There is bad stuff in anything that you can do.
That's right.
It's bad stuff in television.
That's right.
But it's all about how you use it.
Amen.
And so we use it to glorify God. It's not about glorifying me or the church minister or senior pastor,
right,
but it's all giving glory to the Lord.
That's, right.
That's what we're about in this ministry.
Right.
We do thank God for those of you who are calling, and we do solicit your prayers for the ministry. And we also ask that if you would like to call us during our national television hour, which is from 3 to 4 p.m. Eastern Time on Sundays. And our telephone number is area code 478-935-8589. And as I said, call us during that hour, which is from 3 to 4 p.m. Eastern Time on Sundays. Most likely someone will be available to answer your call.
Amen.
But if you call any other time through the week, most likely you will be going to voicemail.
Right.
If you leave a message, it will probably be the following Sunday before we contact you back, but we will call you back.
Amen.
So again, we just thank God for everything.
Amen.
That he has done within the ministry, and we're looking forward to what he's going to do.
Amen.
Now we're going to see if everybody ready.
Yes.
To continue forth with your praise and worship. There's the folks who need us coming at this time. The Lord praise as they come. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah.
God
bless you.
Praise the Lord, saint. Praise God. He's worthy to be praised. Hallelujah. Praise God. Praise God.
Amen.
We have come into his house together in his name to worship him. We have come into his house together in his name to worship him. He's so worthy to be praised. I said, he's so worthy to be praised. Yes, he is. I once was a sinner. I once was a sinner.
my Bible.
I am.
What it says.
That I am.
I believe.
What it says.
To believe.
I come.
To the Lion's Supper.
Pentecostal Church.
To be taught.
The Word of God.
I will not.
Serve the devil.
I will not.
Live in sin.
Jesus Christ
died
for my sins
in
the blood of Jesus.
Cleanses me
from all sin.
I am Christ-like.
I am born again.
I have power
over the devil.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
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 Amen. Once again.
Let's go.
Dear Heavenly Father, we give you glory, honor, praise, and worship. We thank you for yet another chance to come before you and also before your people. And Lord, as we go into your word tonight, we pray that it is a word of salvation to the lost, a word of consolation to those who are going through, a word of healing for those who are going through physical ailments, Lord, mental ailments, Lord. We pray right now. In the mighty name of Jesus, that your will be done in your people's lives. Let us all say amen. Amen.
Amen. Amen. And
amen
once again.
Amen.
Let's give the Lord one more hand.
Oh, yes.
You may be seated. Again, we are blessed to be in the house once again. To God be the glory for the things that he has done. We thank him mainly and mostly for saving us from our sin,
amen.
Delivering us out of the hand of the enemy,
right.
Placing us in a position to where we can be a light unto others of the saving, healing, and delivering power of Jesus Christ. We also thank God for the natural people who he used in order to get our attention to see that we needed him. We thank God for the founder of this ministry, Apostle Al Phelps. Him being led by God to establish these churches, this ministry. We also thank God for Senior Pastor Ethel Phelps being there right by his side as a willing and supporting partner in getting this ministry established. We also thank God for the pastor of Messiah Pentecostal Church, Pastor Willie Wooten. Thank God for him being in our service this evening. We thank God for all of our sister pastors, Sister Pastor Dinner, Sister Pastor Walton, Sister Pastor DeShager, and their spouses, all the other ministers of the gospel, deacons, saints, friends. Again, we thank God for everyone being in the service. If you will, go ahead and open your Bibles up, St. John chapter 6. St. John chapter 6. The title of our message for this evening is Bread of Life. Bread of Life. I want to start off with something that most everyone in here can relate. When we were children, quite oftentimes, everything that our parents prepared for us, we didn't like. Sometimes Senior Pastor would prepare meals for the family. And sometimes she may throw some old tomatoes. I'm talking about as a child. Or she might put some cucumbers. And I didn't like it. I used to couldn't stand tomatoes. They were so nasty to me. Or she may have some okra, not the frying pan. and I didn't like it. But quite oftentimes, my parents would make me eat it. Because I didn't understand as a child the benefits of eating vegetables. And as I said, I didn't like it, but I had to eat it. But as I began to grow older, see, I like candy. I like cake. See, I thought, according to my understanding as a child, that I could live, be healthy off of eating cake. That's what I thought as a child. But as I began to get older, I began to learn more about the human body. And I found out that vegetables are very beneficial to our health, to our body. And so I began to eat more of them. Now, it wasn't necessarily that they tasted good, but it was good for me. As I grow older, I began to realize, and I'm quite sure many of you in here can relate, there were some things that your parents prepared for you, especially on the vegetable side, as a child. You didn't like it. It was something you said, when I get to be grown, and I get out this house, I ain't never gonna eat that. But as I said earlier, you begin to mature and you begin to grow and to learn more, and you see the benefits of getting proper nutrition. And you begin to change. You begin to develop an appetite for vegetables. When I was a child, I didn't like turnips. I'm talking about them bitter ones. Seemed like them were the kind my mama had. She didn't put any sugar in her. You know, some people, they put a little sugar in them. So as a child, I didn't like turnips. But now as an adult, I like turnips. I like tomatoes. I like cucumbers. But it's because I matured. I found out that I can't live and be healthy just eating cake. Eating sweets. Now it's a spirit thing we're gonna get to in a little while. But I wanna show you the natural part first. Because you can understand that. You can relate to it. All right, so let's read a little bit here. Everybody should be there now. St. John chapter 6. And to kind of preface everyone to what's going on, Jesus had went over to the Sea of Galilee, and there was a multitude of people that were following him. And they had been following him for some time. And they were hungry. No one had any food. But there was this little young child who had bread and fish. And Jesus told the disciples, right here, he prayed over it. And so the people, over 5,000, just men, and then there were many other women and children in the crowd also. But Jesus fed all of those people out of those few fish and those few loaves of bread. Amen. And he did a miracle.
It did. Amen.
upon doing so, the people then, Jesus felt in his spirit that, hey, they want to make me a king, so that's not my purpose. So he left. He went to the shore and took the disciples ahead of him. And he began to walk on the water to catch up with his disciples. So he sailed across the sea. And so this is where, when he caught up with his disciples, he got on the ship and everything. You can read it all. These early verses in the sixth chapter. But we're going to start on verse 24. It reads, when the people therefore saw that Jesus was not there, neither his disciples, they also took shipping. I'm talking about these 5,000 men, sorry, men and children, and came to Capernaum seeking for Jesus. And when they had found him on the other side of the sea, they say unto him, Rabbi, when camest thou hither? Jesus answered them and said, verily, verily, I say unto you, ye seek me, not because ye saw the miracles, but because ye did eat of the loaves and were filled. See, now Jesus began to tell the people, you looking for me, but you're looking not at the miracles that I've done, but because I gave you some to eat. Natural food.
All right.
See, when they saw the miracle that Jesus had did with the fish and the bread, they went, hey, I want to go wherever he go, I want to go, because he's going to be able to feed me in the natural. But see, Jesus goes so much deeper than just the physical or the natural. So, then he goes on to say in verse 27, labor not for the meat which perisheth, but for the meat which endureth unto everlasting life, which the Son of Man shall give unto you. For him hath God the Father sealed. So he's telling the people, labor not. I don't work for natural meat, which perish. We all know that meat, leave it out long enough, it'll spoil. Bread, leave it out long enough, it'll spoil. Any kind of food, you leave it out long enough, it will spoil. If it don't spoil, there's something wrong with it. You know, they got some Twinkies and stuff, they say it never spoil. You know that's not good for you. Some stuff you throw out there on the ant pile, they won't even eat it. But again, looking at this, what Jesus said, he tell them, don't labor or work for meat which perish, but for the meat which endureth unto everlasting life, which the Son of Man shall give unto you. For him hath God the Father sealed. And he referring to himself. Verse 28 said, then said they unto him, what shall we do that we might work the works of God? 29, Jesus answered and said unto them, this is the work of God, that ye believe on him whom he hath sent. So Jesus tells you, you need to believe on me. Not for what you can get out of me, but believe on me for who I am.
That's right.
So many people, they believe in God and Jesus for what they can get out of him. Lord, give me this. Lord, give me that. And then if the Lord happened to give it to them, then they'll drop off. Okay, so some people the same way. They nice, buddy, as long as they can get what they can get out of it. Then when they can't get it out of you anymore, then they'll drop you off. Then my brother said, they said therefore unto him, what sign showest thou then, that we may see and believe thee? What dost thou work? So now they're asking for a sign. Our fathers did eat manna in the desert, as it is written, he gave them bread from heaven to eat. Now they're trying to throw this up, the sign of how that Moses, through God, was able to feed the children of Israel when they were traveling through the desert. So now they're putting this up to Jesus. We had a sign with our fathers being fed. Bread from heaven, as we read on further, we're going to see what it was, called manna. So now they're trying to say, this happened in our father's time, what you going to do in this time? Right in verse 29 says, Jesus answered and said unto them, this is the work of God that you believe on him whom he has sent. Verse 30, I already read that. Let's go to 31. Our fathers did eat manna in the desert, as it was written, he gave them bread from heaven to eat. Then Jesus said unto them, verily, verily, I say unto you, Moses gave you not that bread from heaven, but my Father giveth you the true bread from heaven. For the bread of God is he which cometh down from heaven and giveth life unto the world. See, that natural bread that the children of Israel received only lasted for a little while. After a while, they were hungry again.
Hallelujah.
But Jesus said,
I come.
And we're going to see in a few minutes that you hunger and thirst no more. In fact, let's go on now. We're going to read that. Verse 34 says, then said they unto him, Lord, evermore give us this bread. And again, they're thinking on the natural. Lord, we want it. So many people say they want it. Well, they say, bread from heaven, feed me till I want no more. That's the song. That's what they say. They say they want it. Okay. Verse 35 says, and Jesus said unto them, I am the bread of life. He that cometh to me shall never hunger. And he that believeth on me shall never thirst. But I said unto you that ye also have seen me and believe not. All that the Father giveth me shall come to me. And him that cometh to me, I will in no wise cast out. For I came down from heaven, not to do mine own will, but the will of him that sent me. And this is the Father, which has sent me, that of all which he has given me, I should lose nothing, but I should raise it up again at the last day. And this is the will of him that sent me, that everyone which seeth the Son and believeth on him may have everlasting life.
Yes.
And I will raise him up at the last day.
Amen.
So now here's Jesus' statement unto thee.
That's right.
They say they want it.
Yeah.
He began to let them know, I am the bread of life. Now we know that in the natural, when we eat food, over a period of time, we're going to get hungry again. And your body will tell you when you're hungry. Some of us, our mood changes. When we hungry, we are easily agitated. When we are hungry. You can't say amen, say ouch. And we're not satisfied until we get something to eat. I'm talking about the natural. Now, whether you realize it or not, God has made us as human beings not only natural, but we also spiritual. And our spirit man desires something. It hungers. It thirsts. And if we lean to our own understanding, our spirit man wants some change. Our spirit man will want something that is not good for us. Now, when I say cake, our spirit man want a party. Want to fornicate. Sensual and sexual desires. And if we don't fulfill those desires, our life just doesn't seem right. And it's not right. Because you need something. Most people in the world, they don't see Jesus as being a bread. But Jesus will, if you ingest him, all the sinful desires, he will change your appetite to where you no longer want the alcohol. You no longer want the drugs. You no longer want all the different sex parties.
Come on now, get it.
See, this is the bread that he's talking about that he'll be. He'll be that bread of life. Because if we lean into our own understanding, we go out there and get that worldly bread, it's going to lead to death. Just like in the natural, we go out and we eat, all we eat is cake. Sweets, fried stuff, and we keep on indulging in that activity. After a while, something in here ain't gonna go right.
Hallelujah.
So spiritually, we need Jesus. Now, after we get saved, see, it's something that you have to keep. That's why every so often you have to eat in the natural.
Right. That's right.
When you get saved, it works the same way. You have to continue to be fed.
That's right.
Nourishing.
Yeah.
Word.
Right.
See, just like sweet stuff, you know, it satisfies the flesh, make it feel good. You know, I'm not knocking what we had yesterday. You know, we had some cupcake yesterday, but them things were off the chain. They were good. But you don't want to just eat cupcakes. Because that wouldn't be good for you. So many people that go to church ministries, see, as I said, that you get excited over stuff that you like, the stuff that's good to you. So many people go to church and they hear messages that it sounds so good, make you want to jump, make you want to shout. Your spirit that.
Amen.
And over time, you know what's going to happen? Your spiritual man is going to get sick.
Amen.
See, you need to go somewhere where you can get some turnips. Go somewhere where you can get some cucumbers. Go somewhere where you can get some tomatoes. I'm talking about in the word.
Yeah.
See, it's not going to be good to you.
All right.
Sometimes the word got to step on your toes.
That's right.
I look at Jesus and his ministry, and I don't see a whole lot of amen and people jumping up and shouting hallelujah when he ministered. Quite often, time when he preached, folk got mad.
Yeah.
he got the same thing, folk don't like. See, that's them terms. That's that salad.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's that broccoli.
Yeah.
Without the cheese.
Yeah. No.
No, some of us, we eat broccoli, don't got a lot of cheese on it. Or it's in a broccoli casserole. We eat it then. But you need to eat some raw. Some steamed. Talking about the bread of life. Jesus, he's the bread of life. He's going to give you what you need, not what you want.
That's right. Amen.
So, in church all the time, and you know, every church service you go to, and it makes you feel good, and you all, everybody leaving out, jumping and excited. Woo, the pastor sure preached today. Ain't stepped on nail toe.
All
right. Everybody toe perfect. Somebody told them to be bruised when they leave the church. You can't be convicted of sin if it's not brought to your attention. See, every one of us who are saved, we have been convicted in our sin. We saw that our way of living, our way of life, was not going to work.
Right. Hallelujah.
The way that we lived was leading to our death.
Amen.
Spiritually and naturally.
Right.
But whenever Jesus intercepted us, it was some thing that he had, and we saw in his word, it kind of hit.
Right.
Oh. Got to love everybody.
Amen.
Woo.
All right.
Somebody hit one cheek, turn it up. If it's up to us, somebody turn out, we're going to turn theirs. Yeah, we're going to turn it over, all right. But again, it's some things that Jesus taught and in his preaching. Again, people weren't excited, weren't jumping.
Right. That's right.
All excited over his messages.
Right. Right.
He made them mad.
Yes, he did.
That's why they plotted and planned to kill him. They just couldn't just kill him. They had to come up with something.
That's right.
Amen.
Had to come up with a lie, some folk to lie. In order to kill him. One time they were going to kill him, he had to disappear. To get out of there. He did it too. They got the stone ready, they ready to rock him. Jumped around, looked around, and he was gone. So it wasn't pleasant. So if you go into a church and every message that you hear, everybody's all happy. Joyful. Again, Pastor Shaw, every Sunday, Pastor Shaw preach.
Yeah.
He preached today. You just being entertained. Shouldn't go to church just to be entertained. See, the purpose of praise and worship is to get your heart, your mind, and your soul prepared for the word.
Amen.
Praise and worship shouldn't be for entertainment purposes. I know that's what it is in many churches. But there's a reason why we open up with songs. There's a reason why we sing the songs that we sing. Because everything that we sing, we want to make sure that we are uplifting the Lord. Uplifting Jesus. We're praising him. We're worshiping him.
Amen.
May have been a time in our life when we were coming up on the rough side of the mountain, but things are better now.
Amen.
is better. Now I'm not going to say it. I'm going to leave it alone. But I'm just trying to get everybody to see that Jesus is the bread of life. He came in order to make us healthy spiritually. He came to give us his word. And his word is not cake all the time. Now it's some cake in there. Eric, just like in the natural, it's all right to eat a little cake sometime. But you don't want to be eating it all the time. So in the word of God, in the messages that are preached, oh, it's okay to have some joy, some laughter, even humor in the message I gave you tonight. There's some laughter and some humor in there. But it's also some seriousness in there. It's also some word of how Jesus came to give us life and for us to have it abundantly. The devil comes to steal, to kill, and to destroy. You go out there and mess around and just his or the world into your spirit is going to kill it. It'll kill you naturally too. Keep on, if you've been drinking alcohol, keep on drinking. Keep on drinking. After a while, something's going to happen to your liver. And it's going to kill you. Going out there doing these hard drugs, keep on doing it. Keep on doing it. After a while, it's going to bust your heart. Go out there messing with all these women or men. Keep on doing it. Keep on doing it. After a while, you're going to catch something.
That's right.
Penicillin not going to kill.
That's right. Come on with
you. That's what any church, church anyway.
Amen.
So any simple activity, if you keep on participating in that activity, after a while, it's going to kill you. It's going to destroy you. And the devil will have fulfilled his wish in your life. The devil don't like anybody. He doesn't like nobody. I'm still probably saying it wrong. I'm trying to say it correct English wise, grammar wise. But the devil don't like nobody. Now I know everybody understands it. He want everybody to go where he's going. He know where his final destination gonna be. See, God prepared a place for him that he didn't prepare for us. But if we make the choice to follow him, we're going to go where he is going. We're going to be in hell. With the devil. And everybody in hell is going to be mad. You know, we don't like to go around where a whole bunch of turmoil and chaos is going on now. Feast. Folks act like they finna start fighting. Now we start excusing ourselves and get out of there. Start, folks start cussing at one another, looking like they finna fight, maybe shoot. We try to move ourselves out of the place. But in hell, everybody gonna be fussing and cussing and fighting. And you can't leave. No way out. Then you're going to be burning. You're going to be in torment. No escape. The time to escape hell is now in this life by making the choice to take on the bread of life. Take on the bread of life, which is Jesus. And he'll give you a fulfilling life. Just like he said that, hey, you take me into you, then you're never hungry, you never thirst again. And he's talking about those appetites that we once had for the world. We hungered after sin. When we were in sin, we hungered after that. We were looking forward to the party. We were looking forward to the club. We were looking forward to the alcohol. We were looking forward to the drugs. We were looking forward to the sexual activities with the different partners.
But after we get saved, that hunger and thirst has been taken away. We no longer desire those things. Because God has taken that old fleshly man, selfish man, and filled it with a heart of love. And whenever you get the love of Jesus in your heart, he's going to make changes. Now, nobody have to tell you to do nothing. And so, again, we just thank God. I hope everyone got something out of our word this evening. Jesus, bread of life. And at this time, we're going to see, do we have...